How is VR adding value in these therapies?
Kiran, when you saw that when you're wearing the device, you're totally disengaged from the surroundings. And that is a big value that VR can add. Because once one wears the device, he's totally cut off. There is a distraction element which is added by the VR, which kind of disengages the mind from recurrent thoughts about disease. So this is being used for pain, this is being used for certain phobias, this is being used for certain obsessive disorders. So the brain unlearns certain faulty mechanisms by disengagement, by distraction, and there is where VR actually is adding value in these different therapies.
So the distraction along with the engagement seems to be the key. But I would, and along with that, our audience would definitely want to understand, how does VR really help someone with chronic pain?
Yes, Kiran, very, very definitely. Because the use of opioids for the pain relief is a big problem globally. There is a lot of misuse, there is a lot of overuse of opioids, and that has to be tackled. And VR is one of the important mechanisms in which this can be handled. And I'll tell you how. It's very interesting. Because pain has got two aspects. One is the actual acute pain which happens at a time of injury, and then the perception of pain which actually causes a long-term disease. It is this perception of pain that should be handled which can cause a long-term relief. What VR does, it distracts a person. It distracts a person from that thought that he is going to have a pain on doing a certain motion. And once he's able to do a motion without pain in the virtual environment, the brain unlearns the mechanism of pain perception. And that is where the chronic pain is going to be handled by virtual reality.